Today we're going to talk about transmogrification inside Outriders, and we're going to start right now. What's up, guys? Reckless here, and welcome back to another video. We all know that a lot of things need to change in Outriders in order to keep the interest of the community there, like new features, such as transmogrification. And if you guys want to see more Outriders content in the form of class builds, legendary farming, official and fan-made lore, news, updates, and more, be sure to subscribe down below and turn on notifications so you never miss out on any video. Now, for those who don't know what transmogrification is, it is also known as transmog, tmog, xmog, or just plain old mog. This feature gives you the ability to replace the appearance of your gear with other items, or allows you to be able to hide a piece of gear. Currently in Outriders, we are allowed to take off our helmet in the options sections, but that's it. Games that actually have this feature are World of Warcraft, Division 2, Diablo 3, Neverwinter, and Destiny 2, to name a few. However, a transmog system is more than just aesthetics. It's a way of life. I don't know why this system isn't in almost every game that there is, or that's coming out. Being able to have the stats that I want on my armor and weapons with the look of another piece of gear is an amazing customization option for our characters. Currently in Outriders, both my Technomancer and my Trickster have the stats that I want with all of the mods that I want on them. Technically, I'm still waiting for one mod on my Trickster, and I'm sure many of you can guess what that mod is. Both of my classes do crazy amounts of damage. I'm talking 300 to 500 mil in expeditions with a team of 3 and on CT-15. But both of my characters look like they pretty much got all of their gear from Walmart or a thrift store. It's really not aesthetically pleasing at all, but it does the damage that I want with the stats that I want. If Outriders had a transmog system, I could change all of that and make my character look pretty badass on top of doing the damage that I already do. Not only that, but if you're chasing after a 3-piece set bonus piece of gear, or you already have it, you can put that gear on and change the look of it to look like a different legendary set, or just change the look of individual pieces. Now, I hate the Cannonball legendary set. It drops everywhere for me even when I don't want it to. But if I could, I would keep my current gloves on my Technomancer because it has all of the stats and the mods that I want on it, but I would definitely change the look of the gloves to look like the gauntlets of the Cannonball just to go with the skull theme of some of the Borealis set. As for my Trickster, well, his helmet makes him look like a moth, so I would definitely change the look of the helmet to either Old Reliable or the Cranium of a Lost Creature. However, while adding a transmogrification or transmog system is a good thing, it could also be a bad thing. For example, anytime the devs add something to the game, it usually breaks something else either in the entire game or a specific platform. Xbox players, I'm sorry for your recent loss. As of this video, since the last update that the devs had released, a lot of Xbox players are still having issues with logging in, but it seems to be account-based. I actually had a viewer say that he still wasn't able to log into the game, but his wife had no issues, and they were both on Xboxes right next to each other. Besides breaking other things in the game, the transmog system could have issues of its own, and it could possibly lead to more inventory wipes, from which, well, we all know what happened the last time we had inventory wipes, and how long it took to get it fixed. So yeah. Maybe this wouldn't be a good idea, because we probably wouldn't want that to happen again. Nonetheless, I actually do feel like adding certain features like a transmod system would be a good idea, even though there are a chance for bad things to happen. And it could even help bring back some of the player base that we had lost due to the inventory wipes. Not everyone will come back, but a few hundred would be nice. Anyways, let me know what you guys think about a transmog system coming to Outriders. Is that something that you would like, or would you rather the devs just fix the game first before adding any extra features? Let me know in the comment section below. And that, my friends, brings us to the end of the video. If you need a place to play Outriders, come join the Everything Outriders Discord. Every platform is welcome. You can make new friends, get help with expeditions like Challenge Tier 14, 15, and Eye of the Storm, get detailed information such as data mines, patch notes, lore, and a look at all of the legendaries in the game as well. We have over 280 members, and it's growing every day, so come and join us. A link to the Discord will be in the description box below, and I will see you guys in the next one. Hey. Hey you, watch these videos too. I know you like them. Go. Go.